We manage what we have. And stop all these things about so much money. It's destroying families. It's destroying homes. But most importantly, it's destroying the children. The children, you have them, you pray to God for these children, hopefully. That's what I'm going to talk about. Purpose-driven parents. And then the children come and they look at other things. In this time, they enjoy their children. We can't imitate it. It's a culture, the same culture the Israelites met when they entered the land of Canaan. And it's just corrupted them. It has entered the church. It has entered the church. That evil culture. And it has affected our parents. And now our children are suffering. Our children are being snatched by them day by day. We have to groom for these children. Praise the Lord. We suggest to them to use social media platforms constructively to enhance their learning or to collaborate with others. You have to be there. You have to be there as a mother, as a father. Sit with these children. Let them use the social media platforms well. Tell them, teach them how to differentiate between what has substance and what is not worth spending time on. And then give them time. Supervise their online activities so you can teach them to protect themselves from online predators and bullies. Give them enough freedom, but ensure they know you are aware of online habits. Now, you can agree to say, look, when you are studying, you can spend 30 minutes. Take a break, 30 minutes, game or this. Make sure you don't go to. When you tell them, you give them instruction, you create the boundaries. Children know. When they are going out of the boundaries, they are the wrong. You say, I just went to that place. They want to go there to the wrong. I'm sorry. Something just dropped. When they talk on their screen, you tell them, don't even touch. Just get off. Because when you say you are trying to remove, delete it, the way it is now, it will delete. It's all to attract children. And there's a certain time of the day when you know children are online. Praise the Lord. Join the social networking site so you can be better aware of how it works. You mommy, join. You daddy, join. Don't say, it is evil. Join so that you know what's going on. Praise the Lord. If possible, follow your children on site so you can see their posts. You change your details so they don't know it is you. If your child is often upset after looking at their phones or their time online, talk to them about it. It is, that's why I say, have a family time. Family time, the best time. That devotion back night in the evening, please do your best to have it. Because we teach the children, I ask them, how many of you pray? Have devotion, morning and evening. Morning, no. And we know everybody's rushing. Evening, we go, you come to bed. The majority. So, a family that does not pray together, their divinity in the home. How will they know their children? The children don't know the word.
There were such and hearts in them that they will fear me and keep all my commandments always, that it might be well with them and with their children forever.
Thank you. That's God talking. Oh, how I wish that they have such a heart in them, a heart that fears me and keep my commandments. That can be well with them and with their children forever. Do you have a heart for God? Say yes. Do you know God? Before going like this, I said no. That is why they looked at you and came and picked you. They said no thing on you. You are just a sitting dog. They came. And so they are waiting for you to manifest. Full manifestation and started telling you. Joshua 1:8, 1:7, and 8. A few other things. I say you have to know God. If you do not serve God, this book of the Lord shall not pass from your mouth, shall not be for the year and night, so that you may be there. All that is written is for any successful and prosperous. It means you have to be inspired day and night. Mornings, you have said, and that is no morning devotion. You understand? But the night devotion, don't play with it. Teach your children. If they know the word of God in their hands, I say, you put your Bible under your pillow, you're wasting your time. When Jesus was tempted, he spoke the word. He didn't say, wait. Let me go and check the Bible, or let me call my teacher. Praise the Lord. So it is you. The word, you spend time, your quiet time, your me time with God. Let the word be inside of you. So you know that the word, you need to be prepared in season and out of season for children who has. Last time, when we had this training, a teacher came, teacher, said, let me rest a bit. Teacher, oh, I want to ask a question, let me rest a bit. It was from his sleep.
willing.
That child wanted to talk to him, was crossing the road, was knocked, and that was it. The child died. And the teacher was waiting for not being available for that child. We have to be available. We have to, as parents, ensure that we teach our children. We spend time, please, if you are not doing it, from tonight, have your study time. Sit down and give the children, as the evangelist Abulabi said, give them roles. This one will read and explain. Then you, the parent, our teacher, you now chip in. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Ensure they spend only as enough time as it is. That is, give them time. Praise the Lord. Praise them. Tell them that having 510 friends on Facebook doesn't mean they are cool. It is not true. Those are not their friends. Those are not their friends. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. My daughter was very ill. She had cancer. And so there was a time she was talking, she couldn't look at the phone. And then the day she picked up the phone, she said, what? This woman didn't even ask for phone. She said, that's the big word. Sorry about that. They are not your real friends. They are just people who follow you. They didn't see you. They didn't ask for you. They didn't even call. They didn't send any message. That's what it is. She was wild. My daughter. But I thank God that she found Christ. She found Christ. Her. 2017, July 19th, she went to be with the Lord at 19. Praise the Lord. What this means, she had lots of friends. She had lots of friends. She was at, what's called, Down Road, at Atlantic University. That's where she was. She had friends. She had friends. And I would talk to her. With the Bible, she would go like this, she would go like this, she would go like this. She would tell me what I do. Everything, me. That's her. Praise the Lord. It's not right. I was on her. But I was the most hated person. I didn't mind. I kept on. She's the one that put me on Instagram. What was Instagram? What do you call it? Nathaniel Bassi. Praise. Say there.
Then she started.
Yes. She started sending me messages. The messages that were said, hey God, this is you. By the time she went to do the video, she was having ready. She came back and was talking to her friends. Said God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We cannot leave them. Let's not leave them. Praise the Lord. Create the balance. Research findings show that many Christian youth have been influenced by social media, positivity, and addiction to pornography. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We need to create that balance so that between social networking and their faith and lifestyle, we must let